Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, all right, welcome back. It's another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper. It's working with this new data bar concept in Excel 2007. I had some topics there and some percentages, and I tried the data bar, and just wasn't what I wanted. I wanted to actually have the data bars appear on the words, not on the numbers. I didn't think this was a good way to go, and there's really nothing you can do. If you make the numbers too small, it's not going to overwrite. So I came up with this idea. I said, what if we would go to that number and control 1 to format cells, create a custom number format where I actually don't have any number showing up at all. In quotes, I put, for example, the word intro. All right. Now, we have 0.5 in that cell, but it's displaying intro. See where I'm headed with this? I'm going to choose the rest of these cells. I wrote a quick little macro here, 3 lines. For each cell in selection, we're going to go to the cell 1 column to the right, so the offset. Set up a number format with, in quotes, the cell.value. Now, I have to put 4 quotation marks there. That's the VBA way to get a single quote to appear. First quote says we're starting a literal. Next 2 quotes puts a quotation mark in, and then finally that last quote ends it. So let's run that macro. We'll go back and check this out. Now we have numbers over there in column B, but instead of having numbers, the words actually appear. So let's left justify that. I can actually get rid of all the words back here in column A. I'll just press delete. And then I can build this into a nice little block of maybe 10 rows by 4 columns. So let's go grab data starting there, control X, control V, good, control X, control V, and then control X, control V. All right, so now this looks like a block of words, but when I apply the conditional formatting is going to use the numbers underneath. All right, check that out. A very cool way to build a nice, concise list of topics, get a data bar on each one. We can see how much change we have in those various topics. I think a much better way than this presentation here, which is going to take up a whole page and really people's eyes are going to glaze over. A lot of information being communicated in a very small space here, using a custom number format to replace the numbers with the actual words to allow the data bar to go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.